So let's try and learn how to solve some first order differential equations that occur actually quite often in applications. So it's a first order equation. So the equation looks like dy dx. And then we're going to have a right hand side then that splits into two terms. So the term on the right-hand side, I will say, is f of x. And then on the left-hand side, we'll have a g of y. Okay? So basically, the right-hand side is f of x divided by g of y. Or you can say that it's just some function of x times some function of y. Okay, together with this, we need an initial condition. So let's say y of x naught equals y naught. Okay, so if an first order of equation is of this form, where the right hand side splits into a function of x times a function of y, and we can write it like this, then we say that the equation is separable. Okay, a separable equation can be integrated. So we integrate this equation. We integrate from the initial value of x. So we integrate from x naught to x. And then we have g of y, which is a function of x, times dy dx. Dy dx is y prime of x. And then we're integrating this dx. So that's the integral of the left-hand side with respect to x, is equal to the integral of the right-hand side, which is x naught to x, f of x, dx. Okay. So the equation is separable, and we integrate it. You can notice that the left-hand side of this equation looks like a typical substitution type of integration. So we can let u equals y of x. That's our substitution variable. And then du becomes y prime of x dx. Okay. Using this substitution, we write the integral. So when x equals x naught, then we have y of x naught, which will be y naught. That's our initial condition, right? Y of x naught is y naught. So we integrate from x naught to x. Y of x is what we call y. And then we have g of u du with the substitution. And that's equal to the integral from x naught to x, f of x, dx. OK? So the first order equation that's separable, written in the form g of y dy dx equals f of x, we can simply integrate and end up with a solution that means that you have an integral to do on the left, an integral to do on the right. And then in many cases, you can then solve this equation for y as a function of x. OK, that's the separable first order equation. In practice, one doesn't do this substitution. In practice, it's much more straightforward to solve an equation like this. So let me show you what one does. In practice, you have this equation, g of y dy dx equals f of x. What you do is you take advantage of this Leibniz notation for the derivative. We know dy dx is not really a fraction. It just means the derivative of y with respect to x. But in this particular situation, you can treat dy dx like a fraction. Okay, so that will eliminate this substitution step. So if you treat dy dx like a fraction, you can write this as g of y dy equals f of x dx. that's the separation stage, where you have a function of y times dy equals a function of x times dx. So it's very important here that you have this dy is multiplying everything here on the left, and there's no x dependence on the left. And this dx is multiplying everything here on the right, and there's no y dependence on the right. So getting to this stage, you then integrate. So here we integrate from x naught to x. That will be our right-hand side here. And on the left, instead of integrate, well, when you integrate from x naught to x, using the initial condition here, when x equals x naught, y is equal to y naught. So you integrate from y naught. And when x is the value of x, then y is the value of y, and you integrate to y. So this equation is the same as this one below. Here, u is a dummy variable, so it commonly just use y as the dummy variable. Y inside the integral has no meaning other than a holding variable, and the true y here is in the limit. Okay, so that's the very, very quick solution of a separable equation. The only thing that's important here is that you have to manipulate the original differential equation. So you have some function of y times dy dx equals some function of x, and then you can multiply through by dx. So let me quickly review. This is a class of first order equations where it's possible to find an analytical solution. It's called separable first order differential equations. The type of equation is such that this general right-hand side, which can be a function of x and y, is possible to separate it into just a function of x times a function of y. And then we can pull the y dependence on one side and the x dependence on the other. And then treat it dy dx as a fraction, as if it was a fraction, and then integrate. We'll see some examples of how to solve equations of this type. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.